Happy Sunday. This is the last live session in September and October's series on moving forward. This is a practice for getting clarity and focus as you move forward. And so rather than remembering all the challenges that we have when we take action and live our lives fully, we're going to remember where we've been by examining and exploring our joints in this total body workout. It's a total body practice, but there is a workout component. So please be kind to yourself and don't forget to practice nonviolent communication. Earth Mother Yoga is expanding. And as such, we would like to invite you to please support us by subscribing, liking, and sharing the content on YouTube. So you can find the links in the text, and I appreciate your support. And I appreciate the support of my significant other giving us beautiful music for this practice. We'll begin by bringing our hands together, rubbing them, today's practice will use familiar postures and movement in a flow to create some warmth in our bodies so that we can explore how our body feels at this present time and walk into tomorrow with a better understanding of ourselves and clarity on where we're going. Bring your hands to the heart center. Close your eyes. Stack the vertebrae one on top of each other, and then just begin to breathe in and out through the nose. Let your focus rest right at the third eye. Just gently press the chest up into the hands. Let the thumb press on the sternum. Drop the elbows down, widen across the collarbones and the shoulder blades. Breathing in and breathing out. Take another deep breath in, bring the hands to the third eye, press gently on the third eye. Tuck the chin slightly, but elongate through the neck. Again, feel the collarbone expand, the shoulder blades expand, take a breath in. And as you exhale, let the hands rest to the lap, bring the head up. We're going to take a couple of breaths in here, rooting down into the earth, bringing your mind's focus on the breath as it flows in and out. Today, as you find the roots in the ground, bring a lightness. Feel that expansion up towards the sky and out of the earth. And using that rootedness, allow yourself a lightness with your breath. Begin with Sufi grinds, inhaling as we go forward, exhaling as we go back. I'm moving left to right. I invite you to do the same or in any way that moves you. Today's Sufi grind is not about lateral movement, but just about feeling the flow within our body as we move around our center with that rootedness and the lightness that we're bringing to our practice today. Feeling the space around the circle that you're making and bringing your awareness into that circle. And maybe feeling that circle holding you there, giving you boundaries on where your body can go at this moment. And feeling into that circle a little bit more, maybe visualizing they space around the circle and expanding a little bit more, maybe with the breath and not so the movement, increasing the circle, increasing the breath. Bring your attention to hitting the edges of the circle with your breath and your body and your visualization. And exhaling, feeling those roots that keep you grounded and centered in this movement. And then coming to center. Letting the chin rest to the chest, relax the shoulders down, let the elbows droop, holding onto the knees gently. Take a deep breath in, feel this length of the neck, lightness of this posture, kind of inviting you to fold forward. And when you're ready, inhale to bring the head back up. Taking the right ear to the right shoulder, you're going to place the left hand on the right shoulder. So left hand on the right shoulder, and I'm sorry, left ear to the left shoulder. Oh yeah, that's it. Roll the chin to the chest. You're going to take that left hand, place it on the forehead. I'm using the heel of my hand, and I'm going to allow my head to come up with the movement of my arm. And then we're going to take the right arm and place it on the left shoulder, right ear to the right shoulder. Take a deep breath in, and as you exhale, roll the chin to the chest. Remove the hand, take the heel of the hand, place it on the third eye, and go ahead and press the head back up. Warming up the shoulders, inhaling up, exhaling down, inhaling up, exhaling down. We're going to get faster and faster with this. Inhale, bring the shoulders up, hold. Exhale, let them go, and little head circles. We'll do the head circles in both directions. Take it slow. Feeling into your head and that head space. Thinking of the circle you're creating. Space around the circle. Breathing into that energy around the circle and visualizing it for what it is and its uniqueness. If it's different than the Sufi grind or more elusive, let the chin rest to the chest and take it in the opposite direction. Allow your body to settle in here. And then breathing into that space that is the circle. Bringing your awareness to the space around the circle. And then letting the chin rest to the chest. Bring the heel of one hand to the forehead at the third eye and press the head back up. Take a moment here. Hands can be in any position. I'm going to place mine in my lap, allowing a little narrowness to my shoulder and a little caving in to my chest just to be more comfortable. Tilting my chin just slightly, I'm going to try to get length through my spine and find lightness with the breath. So we're going to root down, but there's a quality of lightness to it, so that it's almost like you could levitate off the ground, which we'll be doing. So take a deep breath in. Again, the focus at the third eye. Small routine to warm up our body, and this one is meant to be through your full range of motion, so whatever that is for you today. Some days that I am able to get down on the floor and do it fully, and other days I'm not. So this is an exercise for that, and we're going to start in a standing position. And it's basically a sun salutation, so I'm taking a mountain pose, but I'm going to take it a little wider. And then I'll open my legs even wider and turn my feet out to allow my hips to open wherever that is. So with my feet about under my hips, I like a little wider stance for this one. I'm gonna bend my knees and find some buoyancy here. This is dance posture for my dancers, but it's a comfortable position where my pelvis is neutral, and I like to come from sun salutation here when I'm warming up. There is some tension on the quads. It's like I'm sitting on a little bar stool, lifting my chest up, and I'm going to lift my arms overhead, take a couple breaths here. There's a tension in the legs, so it's holding us. That's our earth, while the upper body is floating, and there's a lightness to it. And as I circle the arms behind me, I'm going to take a little squat in front of me with an exhale. Inhaling back up. Settling into my, sinking into my posture. Inhaling, lengthening and floating up. Exhale, circling around. Sitting into it. My chest may drop, and that's okay. I'm keeping my feet flat on the floor. One more time. Inhale. Exhale. So we're going to inhale, lift all the way up, exhale, fold down, let your head hang, soften your knees, maybe clasp the elbows, give yourself a little wiggle here, allow the head to hang, just notice what you're feeling. Stiffness, sometimes even discomfort, settling in here, finding that comfortable place to assess and let go. Releasing the hands down, we're going to place them under the feet. We need to bend the knees for this. I'm going to place the hands palms up under the feet. My knees pretty soft. Try to take my tailbone over my heels, which is very difficult. Maybe a little bend in the knees, and then let my head hang, stepping gently on my wrists, letting my elbows open up. Again, broadening through the back of my collarbone to let my neck hang. Releasing out the feet, taking the hands on the ground, stepping wide again, and again, I'm going to come up, inhaling, circle around, exhaling, squatting. This time I can go a little lower, or more time. Inhaling and exhaling. In a squat position, I'm letting my knees drive out, screwing my feet into the earth, but there's a lightness to my upper body. Bringing the hands into Namaste. Concepts we're working on today, which is clarity. So let the brain rest in the back of the head as the inner gaze goes towards the third eye. Feel that lightness, but feel the rootedness of the hands and the feet. The breath as it plays in the body. The sensations are physical. On the toes, exhale, bend the knees as deep as they can go, and round into a plank. Inhale, back up. Exhale, bend. Inhale, round. Got one more of these. Inhale, back. Exhale, bend. Here. to feel the evenness between the knee and the hand. Lowering the foot down, we're going to take the hand up to the sky and then thread it through. Let the side of the head rest on the floor. I like to use my support of my right hand to help me on the left side rather than putting it all on my neck. But you can also wrap around, so you can also take the bind if you want it behind you. What do you feel between the shoulder blades? Find that neutral position again. Toes stay pointed, and now we'll be taking the opposite hand. So the right arm, left leg. Find the earth here. And find that lateralness right at the edge of parallel. To the sky and then thread it through. Hollowing out the belly, dropping the forehead, stretching the arms back, becoming tiny. Hip width apart, I'm going to come all the way up and sit back into my squat again. So I'm going to draw my tailbone deeply, really sweep all the way up, stretch back, circle the arms behind me, and hit my squat. Inner thighs are drawing together, feet are screwed into the ground, chest is lifting up. You could take one arm up. Position, inhale. sit down my dog. Inhale, hold. Come up on the toes. Exhale, bend the knees. Inhale through plank. Exhale to the earth. Inhale, cobra or upper dog. Exhale, lower to the earth. Bring the feet a little wider apart. Kind of scooch your rear end down. Bring the hands by the shoulders. We're going to go up again. Helps to have the knees out a little bit, but still lots of play. So I'm really pointing my legs, pushing into the earth, finding that earth here. I'm going to lift up into a little cobra. And then I'm going to bring my legs up towards my head, using the strength of my arms just to get a little stretch here. Downward dog. Inhale, look at the hands, walk the feet into the hands, soften the knees, hang forward again, letting the elbows, releasing into your elbows so that you can get a nice long stretch. Feel this move now. Snuggle in there. To an arch. up to the sky. You feel pretty good here. Put a little bit more weight into the shoulder, making sure the shoulders are stacking on top of each other. And you'll know. You'll be able to feel it. Exhale, thread that arm through. Go back into a nice child's pose with a stretch. Up onto the hands and knees. Bring the feet out as if we're already out. Adjust your position. Inhale. Exhale. Tuck. Inhale. Extend. Exhale. Tuck. Come up on the fingertips. Shoulders on top of one another. My arm is not locked out, but you can see the stretch on this side is a little harder. Breathing here. Finding where I'm rocking off the earth and giving in to the twist. Maybe widening my base here. And then threading. In any comfortable position, but as we're gonna assess our knees, so I'm gonna sit on my heels and make adjustments to see if I can sit on my heels today, which I can. It's very nice. But you can also pad up, and this is a really great posture to see where you are And then you know when you need to revisit it. Like if it's not comfortable, you can cushion up, and if that's still not comfortable, you come to sit. You can do yoga just about anywhere. You don't really have to do the posture to get the benefits of it. But I like to try them all out, because if my knees can bend like this, it's probably gonna be a little easier to get up the stairs to my classroom. So, so it's nice to visit this every day, and this practice is for remembering past injury and being kind to myself. So, resting here, bringing your awareness back to your breath. To the mystery and intrigue of being in this position, we're going to do a Sufi's grind. So the hands come to the knees, if your little short arms can reach it. It kind of makes you sit up a little taller and then sit your hips down into it. So it gives you a little different posture, and it's pretty challenging. Inhaling forward and exhaling back. Again, I invite you to go to the left, or in whatever direction calls you. And I'm trying to find my rootedness in the earth, but an ease to the orbit about myself. And visiting it in different postures makes you understand the way you move in different settings as you leave a map to the future. A new day. And stopping forward, we're going to take it in the opposite direction. Trying to bring an ease to something that doesn't feel natural. Opportunity to rest whenever you need it. When movement evades you, that's a good time to reassess and hit center and stay there. And that exploration helps us move forward. Coming to center, take a deep breath in, arch the back, exhale, round the spine. Inhale, lift up. Exhale, round. Inhale. And exhale. And then when you're ready, take your time to transition over to one side. Bring the legs out in front. I'm going to bang the big toes together right at that little knobby thing if you can, and that releases the tension out of the knees and the hips. The last movement that we're going to do before I end class is a movement that we've done before. It's a hold of a forward fold. And I'm gonna take you into a comfortable seated, comfortable forward fold. And then I'm gonna let you go from that position. I'm gonna play a little drum. I have it behind me to say goodbye. And this is a really great way to end a day. Sitting on the knees like we just did is supposedly very good for your digestion. And so, it said if you sit on your knees like that for 3 minutes quietly, that you'll be able to digest food. So, and it's pretty good at moving and your digestion after you eat. This is a good movement before you go to bed, and it's a great way to end practice, and it's a great way to check in as you will be enclosed within yourself in this. So I'm going to get you into the posture, and then I'll be moving around. And after I finish playing, I'll take us out of the posture and say goodbye. Take a deep breath in. We have the legs out in front. I have my feet together and my knees bent, and that's the gymnast in me, so, and the dancer in me. Like, you can be a little bit, you know, a little bit less rigid than I am, but I'm digging my heels so I can feel the earth. You want to be supported, so some people even bend their knees. They have a little cushion underneath them. You do that as well. Either way. Feet can be a little wider, too, if you need to accommodate. You're going to drop your chest towards your knees, so you're going forward, and then you're going to relax. After you get that structure, you want to relax in it. So take a deep breath in here, lengthen the spine, feel what it feels like to be upright and in the world, and exhale and begin to walk down. You do not have to grab your feet, but if you want to grab your big toe with your thumb and your index finger, go ahead and hit that spot for a moment. Feel the depth of that stretch. And once you feel like you've hit a comfortable edge where you could remain here and explore, release the tension by letting the feet go, letting the hands go. Just breathing in and out. As you breathe in and out, make a conscious effort to be aware of the space around you, of your skin breathing the air. Of the body parts that touch the earth. Of the way the moment tastes. I have incense burning. Smell the smells of the space that you're in. Listen to the soft sounds in your room, the buzz of the air condition, the sound of someone in the other room, the little cat that scratches at the doormat, the sound of rain on the windowsill. And the sound of music, which is healing. Thank you. As you take a deep breath in, bring your awareness into the room. If your hands are not already on the ground, place them on the ground. Feel the earth with the fingers. And take your time, maybe 2 or 3 breaths. Press into the earth. Assist yourself as you roll up. As you come to the very top, leave the legs extended if you need to. Maybe tap the big toes together, as we did before. And then fold into a comfortable seated position. We'll end together, bringing the hands together, rubbing them, bringing yourself into the room. After a forward fold, it's often good to lay down. So take this time to take about 5 minutes to go ahead and lay flat on the earth, breathing into that space that you're creating with your presence. In a space that becomes you, bringing the hands to the heart center. Take a breath in and out. Again, settling in, feeling that connection with the earth and a lightness as you inhale and exhale. And bringing your intention for moving forward into your third eye, into the awareness of where you go from now with clarity, in peace and love. I wish you many blessings and Sat Nam, Namaste. If you enjoyed this video, please subscribe to our channel and share the content. Earth Mother is expanding, and we look forward to expanding with you. Thank you so much for your support, and I'll see you next Sunday.